was quiet.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Maybe she was abused by her father or friend or family member or something else, or maybe she was raised by a domineering mother. That stuff won't disappear just because the husband comes on the scene. Mm. Our wives need our sanctifying love. The result of a husband's sanctifying work is a wife who has not a spot or a wrinkle. These are the picturesque terms. Spot, as it is used here, represents defilement from the outside. And many women have been defiled mm-hmm. from the outside, mm-hmm. and they come into your life, and you further defile them. God says, you're going to pay for your defilement.
Yes. Mm.
Because she came to be loved. She came to be held. She came to be loved. She came to be rescued. She came she thought she was coming, thank you, Holy Spirit, to a better covering.
Yes.
If I can say it like that. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Wrinkles have to do with internal aging. Mm. Most women are into covering that up because they don't want the wrinkles to show. Wrinkles are evidence that we're getting older. Mm. The church has spots, the external stains of the world, and wrinkles, internal aging and decay. Mm. Jesus said, my job is to wash off the spots and remove the wrinkles. The husband's job is to work with his wife in such a way that she begins to see a cleanup take place in her life. Watch this now. Mm. What this means is that when your wife needs strength, you are her strength. Mm. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
She's got to get on the phone, call her buddies, call her friend. Matter of fact, husband and wife ought to be best friends.
Amen.
Best friends, because if you have a best friend outside the house, then you're going to have some problems.
Amen.
I'm always talking to this one, you're always talking to that one, you're always talking to male or female or whatever else. That's your best friend. Well, go be with your best friend. You follow what I'm saying?
And amen.
Causes, I'm talking by experience now. You cannot have, watch this, your best friend outside the house.
Amen.
If there's some things that you need to talk about on the inside or talk about with the woman of God or the man of God, then that's what you do. Amen?
Amen.
What this means is that when your wife needs strength, you are her strength. When she needs encouragement, you are her encouragement. When she needs joy, you are her joy. When she needs peace, you are her peace. The result is that no matter how old she gets, your wife is kept eternally young because she got a sanctifier in the house.
Amen.
Woo! Lord, have mercy. That's good,
amen.
Amen. Amen. That means you're sanctifying her. You're setting her apart. You're helping her through the process. You're doing whatever you need to do for that. The husband said, well, if she hadn't screamed at me, I would have screamed at her. This is not a tit for tat. What I'm talking about is showing strength. Husband, you say you're the leader. You say you're the strong one. Then be that. Be your wife's sanctifier, that she might be cleansed. For the true purpose of leadership is not domination, but glorification. Mm. It is our goal to glorify and beautify our wives, when we will not abuse them, but embrace them. Yes. You are the head, but she's the neck that turns it. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
My girl said, hello, I got it. Look at your husband real quick and say, you're the head. But I'm the neck that turns it. He cannot do anything. Turn his neck. He can't look left. He can't look right. He can't snap it. He can't do anything.
Yes.
Because that's why. Let's read that last scripture together. 1, 2, 3. Read. Come on. The same.
The same goes for your husbands.
Go ahead.
Be good husbands to your wives. Honor them. Delight in them. As one, they lack some of your advantages.
Come on.
But in the new life of God's grace, you're equals. Treat your wives then as equals, so your prayers don't get run aground.
You know why a lot of men of God's prayers are just hitting the ceilings? Because they don't treat their wives right.
Mm.
And it just bounces off the wall. When you take a minute and read that whole scripture in 1 Peter, the 3rd chapter, it talks about the wife, it talks about her adornment, it talks about that she's the weaker vessel. There's no way. You all can sit here with your little junior Holy Ghost selves if you want. But we as men are going to pay for not treating our wives correctly.
Mm-hmm.
Got it?
Amen.
All right, that's part 2. You can stop. We go to part 2 now.
Okay.
Any questions?